Hola, I'm Mike, the backyard mechanic, and I'm reposting a video. You may recall that my last repost was insulating and flooring the attic over my garage. After doing that, I thought, how much can an attic hold? Am I overloading it? So as usual, whenever I don't know something, I make a video about it. This was originally posted on my other channel, What Did Mike Do Now? I'll be merging all three of those videos into Mike the Backyard Mechanic and shutting the other one down. YouTube was so impressed with that channel that they didn't know what to do with it. They were so impressed, in fact, that they rewarded me with 150 views. It's not easy to start a new channel. So I'm showing it here. Now, how did that video start? Hola! I'm Mike, and what did I do now? I may have overloaded my attic, that's what. Collapse is imminent. This stack of boxes containing old comic books probably weighs 100 pounds, which I believe blows away the weight limit for a standard attic. I had a dream last night that everything collapsed. To be safe, I put caution tape around the area of my garage below where my comic books are stored. This is not the scenario I had in mind for my three-car garage. Am I going to have to take all the stuff down and store it in the garage anyway? That would be a nightmare. Let's figure this out. Before calculating the actual weight limit of my attic, let's establish some terminology, starting with some roof types. The face of a roof is called a roof plane, and it's also called the field of a roof. The top edge is called a ridge. The point where two roof planes meet to form a sloping ridge is a hip. The concave internal corner between two hips is called a valley. The vertical wall under a roof is a gable end. No, you do not need to know all these terms. Yes, this was an excuse to use my drone. The two most common types of roof systems are truss and rafter. I'm not going to do a deep dive or do pros and cons, but a truss roof is a web of 2x4s, making it stronger than a rafter roof in some ways. But it does not leave a lot of room to create storage or living space. The exception would be an attic truss, specifically made to create attic space. I have a rafter roof, which has a lot of space and is more conducive to storage. The focus of this video will be on rafter roofs. It's a good idea to have a solid understanding of your structure before modifying it, unlike what I did before, doing it the other way around. For example, I have been referring to the beams on where I laid flooring as rafters, but they're actually joists. 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 Is that one syllable or three? Specifically, they are called ceiling joists. The job of the rafters is to be the base for the roof decking. The shingles are nailed to the decking. The joist job, believe it or not, is to keep your roof from collapsing. The roof is pretty heavy, as you might imagine, and it is putting outward angular pressure on the walls of your house. Joists are tie rods that connect the rafters on opposite sides of the roof, preventing the walls from bowing outwards. Without joists, your house would collapse like a house of... like a joistless house. The joists complete a triangular shape, which is very strong and prevents wall splay. Always splay and neuter your roof. A strutting beam typically spans load-bearing walls to help brace the roof. It's the center of my attic, but it has no effect on the joists or the storage load. This is a collar tie. It prevents the rafters from separating under load. These are struts, and these are purlins. The final term is a strong back. A strong back is a horizontal bracing used to stiffen and distribute loads across ceiling joists. There are three types of attics: uninhabitable attics without storage, attics with limited storage, habitable attics. Not habit trail, habitable. A habitable attic is a space that can be accessed with a door or stairs and is generally built as strongly as any other room supported by joists. An uninhabitable attic without storage is something assigned by a building code. Generally, these are attics with low roof lines or too many trusses to move around easily. It is not suitable for living or storage due to safety or structural factors. An attic with limited storage can hold some storage but has weight, access, or environmental restrictions. It might have partial flooring or an access ladder. This is the type of attic we will be focusing on. This table shows the weight limits for each type of attic. A habitable attic holds up to 40 pounds per square foot, which again is about the same as your upstairs bedroom. An attic dedicated as limited storage can hold half that. You'll also hear the terms live load and dead load. Most dead load specifications are 10 pounds per square foot, whereas live loads vary. The table I showed are live loads. A dead load is the structure itself. This includes a ceiling, sheetrock, insulation, or flooring. If your particular dead load is less than 10 pounds, it does not increase your live load because it could be that the structure weighs less and can hold less. In general, we only care about live load. If you interpreted all that information the way I did, if you have a 20 pounds per square foot attic and you weigh 175 pounds, you'll fall through the ceiling, right? So 20 pounds per square foot does not exactly make sense because I can walk around in my attic. Hell, there were guys a lot bigger than me walking around up there carrying a 500 pound AC unit. Wherever I look for specifics, it always says to consult a structural engineer. So let's do that. I have one nearby. Let's give one a call. What? You don't have a structural engineer on speed dial?
Hello, this is Pete, the structural engineer.
Hi, I was wondering if you could tell me how much weight my attic can hold.
It can hold 20 pounds per square foot.
So, how come I don't fall through the ceiling?
Because it can hold more than your weight.
But I weigh more than 20 pounds.
Yes, I'm sure you do.
Can I put a 100-pound box of comic books up there?
I don't know. I would have to see how your attic is constructed.
Cool. How much to come out?
$500.
That's a hell of a lot of money.
I have to take measurements and write a report.
How much for no report and I do all the measurements?
$500.
Do you do this on the side? Can you come out on a Sunday and give it a quick look?
Sure.
How much?
$500.
I'm not paying $500 to see if my attic can hold comic books. Although it did get me thinking. Maybe I could do this myself. I found all the formula and lookup tables to calculate the max bend of one of my joists. My joists are southern pine 2x12s, 20 feet long and span 24 inches apart. First, determine the section modulus. Joint width times joint height squared divided by 6. Then calculate the maximum bending moment. Weight times length divided by 8. Get the bending capacity by taking the southern pine allowable bending stress, multiplying it by the section modulus. Convert to foot-pounds. Calculate the total load capacity. Since the joists are 2 feet apart, the load per square foot is 580 at mid-span. Before doing these calculations, I didn't know what a strong back was. I know they weren't referring to me. I thought this board running across my joist was just to carry the gas pipe. It actually distributes the weight. So, adjusting for distributed load, and the result is a ducky. I drew it in between equations. On this page, you can see that my attic can hold 5,000 pounds. Hey, I'm going to change the name of my channel from What Did I Knew to I Did Math. Holy crap, I was worried about putting comic books up there. I can put my car up there. I'm gonna try that right now. You're probably wondering how I got my Mustang into the attic. I just went up there and set it down. Wait, you didn't think I meant this Mustang, did you? Of course I meant this Mustang. Can I put 5,000 pounds in my attic or only 20 pounds up there? There seems to be a minor discrepancy. What I just calculated was the max bend of my joists. Yes, I could put my car up there, but the joists would bend about 4 inches. So, there are a couple of things to be taken into consideration for live load. Wood is not consistent, like steel. So while a 2x12 southern pine board is incredibly strong, the grain could vary, there could be too many knots, or there could be cracks. Age and weathering has to be factored in for safety. How old are the boards? Have they ever gotten wet or moldy? Importantly, you don't want so much weight up there that your ceiling bows 4 inches. Sheetrock can only bend so far before it cracks, and that's not even talking about nail pops. And finally, time is a factor. Yes, I could put my car up there, bend a joist, and crack my ceiling, but after a few days, it could fall through. However, the pertinent issue is my comic books could crack my ceiling. So, we're kind of back to square one. The main section of my attic is 20 by 20 feet, and at 20 pounds per square inch, I have a total live load capacity of 8,000 pounds. This is real, not theoretical. Okay, how did I go from a theoretical 5,000 pounds to a real 8,000 pounds? The 5,000 pounds was a calculation of what it would take to bend four joists to their limit. I could place 20 pounds of weight in every square foot, and it will hold. A car in the center is not evenly distributed. So how about 80 pounds of comics? The box has a bigger footprint than 1 square foot, but let's assume it does. You could place the 80 pounds of boxes here, near the middle, and because of the strong back, it will distribute the weight amongst 4 joists, meaning yes, the attic is holding my comics safely. But note the areas of distribution are now claimed, so I cannot put another 80-pound stack of comics here. Now there are 2 joists that are double their load capacity. Could I put a second stack here? Well, yes, mathematically. Realistically, you don't want to pull out your scientific calculator and start doing algebra every time you put a box in the attic. One of the things you may have been thinking about, besides how insanely handsome I am, is why do I keep talking about putting something dead center? Obviously, the joists are stronger when you get closer to the supporting walls. This is absolutely true. In fact, I created this table to help illustrate how much weight you could put where. Yep, you can put as much as 2,400 pounds above a load-bearing wall. This is real, not mathematically theoretical. Let's see. 150 comics per box, 20 pounds per box. I could put a stack of 18,000 comics up there. What I'm getting at is you don't need math. Put the heavy stuff against the wall, and the stuff 20 pounds or less can go in the middle. And yes, to you sticklers out there, the comic boxes are 20 pounds, and I could leave them in the middle, but not stack them. So how much weight can your attic hold? I need to emphasize that my answer is for entertainment purposes only. You should consult a structural engineer. Remember, I'm only referring to rafter and joist roofs. I'm not referring to a truss. They do not hold as much. I don't know the condition of your joists. A 1950s house does have the same 20 pounds per square foot rating, but it's also 70 years old. All that aside, the answer is, yours holds the same as mine. In general, due to building codes, all attics have the same rating. A 20 by 20 attic will hold the same amount per square foot as a 10 by 10 attic because the 20 by 20 will have more support and stronger materials. The third bay of my garage uses 2 by 8s and it's also rated for 20 pounds per square foot. The overall recommendation is to put the heavy stuff against a load-bearing wall and keep everything else under 20 pounds. This table can be used for how much can be placed away from the walls, and I'll put that in the description. Your ceiling won't likely collapse, but keep an eye on cracks, which indicates overloading. As for me, I moved the comics above a load-bearing wall, and now I feel comfortable enough to remove the caution tape. Oh, I have a fan online! Hey, fan! Did you like the video?
Whoa! How much can you put in an attic like that? Maybe you don't need to be buying comics by the pound.
Thanks, fan! If you made it this far into the video and you haven't liked and subscribed, What's wrong with you? You do realize my next video will be how I almost got killed by a tree? Well, I guess you wouldn't have. But you do now, so do it. Generally, these are addicts with low...